Hi guys, my name is Harvansh and thanks for watching my other video about the SCCM tutorial where you was learning so many things about the SCCM. So I will not waste time to explain that what was there. You can go back to my the channel. There is a playlist for SCCM tutorials. Okay, so this video is about the boundary. In my last video, I was explained about the discovery method. That was like kind of a video deep dive. Okay, so if you have not watched, you can go there and you can understand how the discovery is running in SCCM. Now, after the discovery, the topic is a boundary. So if your machine is discovered or like you want to use the boundary. Okay, so let me explain you what is the boundary. Boundary is a limitation set for the client. Like I have a company and in a company like a once.com is a domain, and in that I don't want to manage entire things and whatever running in my infra. I want to use some specific. Can be like a subnet, can be like a IPv6 prefix, it can be a IP range, or it can be a site. So when I'm putting some filter, like I want to manage on this particular, and I have a setup of criteria that called like a boundary. So I'm setting a boundary limitation to my client. Okay, particular in this area, client only will talk to my SCCM, and SCCM gonna manage only these particular machines. So that managed by the boundary feature in SCCM. So how will use it? Let's see. In boundary, you just right click and create boundary. Here you can give the test boundary, and here you can see in it a boundary. Like if I am setting up a boundary, means I am creating a limitation to my client. So on what basis I can do it? On so I have the four option here, like a IP subnet. So if I have the IP subnet and I want like only under this particular IP subnet, I want to manage this client. So I can define here a IP subnet, and under this IP subnet, whatever machines will come, that only will managed by SCCM. Okay, rest of the machines SCCM will not manage. Even I'm not saying it will not discover, client will not install, but it will not manage. Means if you run the discovery, all the machines will come there based on your discovery in SCCM. Okay, after your discovery, client will install. Okay, you use the post installation or the manual installation, that also done. But the point is, when the after client installation, when client will reach to SCCM to take the policy or any update, so SCCM will not allow to give him any kind of information. So it will like a reject there because it not registered. So if that client comes under the boundary area, so SCCM knows, okay, this is the my person, I have to give the information, or I know this is a known IP to me, this is not a unknown IP or the host name to me. If it is like a known to SCCM, then only SCCM will give the policy information, or you can do then the any other task like the application deployment, the your patch deployment, or any other task you can do it. But if your client is not registered, you can't do anything, and that registration will happen based on your the boundary only. So let's come back here. Boundary can define on the IP subnet and the Active Directory site. So when you are in your production environment, you will be having the so many sites. I don't have, just I have the default site. So you can set up the criteria based on your Active Directory site, and you can set up the IPv6 prefix. You can define here in this. If you set up this under this, whatever machines will come, that will manage by SCCM. Rest of the machines SCCM will not take care, and the IP range. Okay, so suppose you have a subnet, and in that subnet you want to manage particular specific IP range. Means like you have the 500 machines, under the 500 you want to manage only the 200, but the problem is these 500 machines comes under subnet. So if I'm the giving subnet, then SCCM will understand, okay, I have to manage the 500 machines. If I'm giving the site, Active Directory site, and these 500 machine is available under the Active Directory site, so that also concept failed because it will manage 500 site. But no, I want to manage only the 200 machines out of 500. So in this scenario, my IP address range will work. So in IP address range, I will collect the IP address and I can define here. So I will be creating a boundary based on the IP address. In between those two IP addresses, whatever machine will there, that machine only managed by the SCCM. Okay, so let me define this 192.168.80 and 0. 192.168.80, and here I can give 10 20 30. I don't have the IP range more than 20, and the again is a boundary group. Okay, so let me apply this and I will explain you now the boundary group. So here we can see if there is any other feature. Okay, so here is a site also, but here no site is reflecting because site can be defined under the boundary groups. Okay, so let's come to the boundary group. What is the boundary group? Boundary group is a setup of the boundary. Okay, so when I have like a 10 20 30 or 1000 boundaries, how I gonna manage it? Okay, so I cannot go each and one boundary property and set up my the site. Okay, site means like a DP. I cannot define like my machine when it's communicating to SCCM, and I want my this machine should take an update from particular this DP. When such kind of scenario is there, then how will manage? So we have the boundary group where we can add the multiple boundaries. We can club multiple boundaries and create a boundary group. Okay, when you are clubbing multiple boundaries, that called a boundary group. And in boundary group, when you are defining any site server, any DP you assign there, so in that particular boundary group, and they are under the boundaries, and under the boundaries, whatever machines are there, these all the machines will take a update from your that assigned distribution point. So I hope guys it's clear. Let me create a boundary group. So it's a test bg, and here I can add boundary. Okay, I have only the one boundary, or if you have the multiple boundaries you can select and add it here. And here you can see in the site assignment. Okay, so why the site assignment is here? So when the client is getting a discovery, okay, so there should be something like who will manage this. Suppose there is a 3-4 sites are there and your discovery is done, and you want to define or tell to that client, okay, when you discover, after discover you have to talk to this site code, so this site code gonna manage to you in future. Or when you are pushing a client after the discovery, then this site code automatically will assign to particular that client. So that's why we are having the site assignment here. I have only the one site. If you have the multiple sites, you can give that site assignment. So site assignment will happen under the this group, and under the group whatever the boundaries will come, and again in that boundaries whatever your machines will come. So all machines will assign to particular this site. And let's see the same ways DP. So here I have the two DPs. So one DP in SCCM and one server is SCCM DP. So I assign this DP. Now what will happen when my machines comes under these boundary group, related to these boundary group, and these machine will talk to this DPE, SCCM.once DPE, to take any kind of update. Like I deployed any package, so from which DPE my machine will take a package, that we can define it here itself. So when my client will get a policy and it requesting for a package, so where it will go, SCCM will tell to that particular client, like, boss, you are related to this boundary and your boundary is associated to this group, and this group is bounded particular this DP. So that client will contact particular the DP to take the package. So that's how this is working. And here is this one more concept come, like overlapping. Okay, so what happened, you create a boundary, and in that boundary you given one client in one boundary, and you create one more boundary, and some of the criteria match, and that clients comes under the that client part of the another boundary also. When client is a part of two boundaries, if you added so when it comes under the two boundary, it will called like a overlapping boundary. When the overlapping boundary happen, then it will be a problem. If you added both the boundaries to a same boundary group, so this problem will not happen. But if you added that two boundaries in a different boundary group, and that boundary group again it associated with the different DP, so in this scenario the overlapping will happen and your client will not get the right information and it will not contact to the right DP. Okay, so here is this much only, guys, and let me check anything else. So here this I explained, reference I explained, security, you can set up the security and scope, role and scope. I will show you in my the coming videos how you can use the security scope and the security role and the security scope. Okay guys, so thanks for watching this video. I hope you learn something about the boundary and the boundary groups. Thank you guys, see you soon in my next video.